This is the 5 reasons why you should not publish fiction books. And this is for you if you're here just to make money and you're deciding between should I publish nonfiction or should I publish fiction? What's the better business move for me? But if you love writing fiction books, then that should not stop you from creating a fiction publishing business. This is only from a perspective of nonfiction versus fiction. Which do I choose if my goal is to make money? From a business standpoint, which is better? 5 reasons why fiction is not the answer. Let's go talk about it. Now, before we get into the 5 reasons why, I just want to talk a little bit about our experience with fiction and why our opinion matters and why and how we know about this. So I've published fiction myself for about a year in 2017 and 2018. In total, I published like 8 books, spent a lot of money, went all out. So I know everything that goes into it.
Yeah.
I know the entire process and what it takes. So I published fiction for around 4 or 6 months. I only published 4 books, 1 trilogy and a standalone in the crime thriller niche, I believe.
Yeah, I did crime thriller and a romance.
So you've had more experience, you've gone deeper into it, and you've as well had a bigger loss with fiction and learned more about it.
I took a course on it, I did everything.
So just want to let you guys know that we do have experience. Now, the first reason why you should not publish fiction books that we think is because it is not beginner friendly, like at all. Now, the great thing about publishing and what separates it from all these other online business models like
nonfiction publishing,
why it is so great, like, and what separates it from all these other online business models is just how easy it is, how beginner friendly it is. It's just, in our opinion, the best online business for someone who's never done anything business related in their life ever to get started.
Now, it's not easy, but it's easy compared to other online businesses out there.
Yeah.
Right. Now, that's why I recommend it to everyone for that reason.
But fiction publishing is not easy at all. It requires you to learn all these other things that nonfiction publishing does not necessarily require, like running Facebook ads, like really in-depth list building, email marketing, building a website, learning how to nurture and build relationships with customers. It's just book launches, just these crazy things that are not easy for someone who doesn't know what they're doing.
That's not to say they're bad in any way. I'm just saying if you have no experience at all with any of these things, it's very tough.
Yeah.
It's very hard. And that was kind of me when I first got into it. I was very overwhelmed. Like, I was not, because I was used to nonfiction, so I was like, okay, fiction seems like it's a good opportunity. Let me try this out. I was very overwhelmed with all the work it was.
That's the big takeaway from this first point, the O word. It's very overwhelming for beginners.
Yeah.
Because it's not what you think it is. There's a lot that goes into it.
Now, the second reason why we do not recommend fiction publishing is because to make money with it, you are basically only relying on ebook sales and page reads. You are removing essentially 2 income streams that are paperback sales and audiobook sales.
Which are normally the 2 biggest income streams.
Yeah, they are. The reason for this is because nonfiction readers and fiction readers act very differently.
Completely different.
Fiction readers, they just love to read. It's really like their favorite thing to do in the world. So they read like dozens a month, right? Now, if they're to buy paperback books or audiobooks, that gets really expensive. And also storing a paperback books, hundreds in your house is tough.
Yeah, it just doesn't work.
But they have ebooks on their Kindle reader, and like all it takes up is this little. They can have hundreds on there. So they buy only ebooks, and then they also enroll in the Kindle Unlimited program, where you get unlimited ebooks that are enrolled in the program for $10 a month. So for them, it just makes sense.
Yeah.
Right? But because of that reason, they will rarely ever buy paperback books and also audiobooks.
Now, paperback books can have like $10 royalties. Audiobooks can have $6, $7, $8 royalties, while ebooks have like $2 royalties.
Back when I ran my own fiction publishing business, I sold hundreds of ebooks, probably not thousands, but over 1,000 ebooks in my span of doing that. I probably sold less than 10, I'll be safe and say less than 20 paperbacks in that same span.
Yeah.
Definitely.
And same for audiobooks?
Same for audiobooks, I would sell less than 20 per book. And I would spend $350 to get these books produced, these audiobooks produced. And they, the audiobooks never made their money back.
Yeah.
The investment to get the audiobook made never came back.
So the big thing is that fiction books rely on one income stream, which is just ebook sales, and then ebook page reads. And they're neglecting the 2 other biggest income sources that nonfiction publishing takes advantage of, paperback books and audiobooks. And the third reason is that it is much more expensive to have books written and thus also audiobooks narrated. Now, if you really want to take fiction publishing seriously, you have to create long books. You can't just create short stories. So a long book would be something in the range of like 50,000 to 70,000 words.
That Right, if you want to compete with the other big popular authors.
Which is what you have to do.
Now, people do publish 20,000 word fiction books.
But they fail, and they don't...
that's not a long-term sustainable thing to do.
Again, the reason why you want long books is because you're based off of page reads. The longer your book is, the more page reads you get, the more money you make. So it is in your best interest, if you're taking it seriously, to make long books. Like 50,000 plus words, which will cost you over $1,000 to have written, and then to have the audiobook narrated, like $300, $400, $500, could be way more than that as well. $500 to have it narrated. While with a nonfiction book, it's more around like 30,000 words long. So the production costs immediately cut in half. So that's one big negative with fiction publishing.
Also, if you go on some ghostwriting companies' websites and you want to order fiction writing, you'll notice that it is often more expensive than nonfiction writing.
The per 100 word rate to have fiction content written is simply just more expensive than nonfiction. So like it just can get really, really expensive, and this is things that people don't talk about.
Yeah.
But this next point is probably the biggest one that people don't talk about.
And that is the upfront cost that you have to spend with Facebook ads to just get your whole fiction business rolling.
Yeah.
I think people don't understand that. Like it's super, super competitive. There are so many authors out there that you're going to be competing with. Facebook ads are a must.
Yeah,
absolutely, 100%.
So that's the thing with fiction. Like, there's no such thing as organic traffic. In nonfiction, there's plenty of organic traffic. You make a book about like how to make a dream journal, and then people are searching how to make a dream journal in Amazon, and then your book will pop up, and you didn't have to pay anything to have someone to see your book. But if you make a book called like Lost in Summer 1988, I don't know, something like that, no one can find your book if you're not running shitloads of ads.
Yeah.
Like there's nothing people can search in the Amazon search bar to be able to find that book.
Yeah.
So you need to run shitloads of ads, and people do not understand how much money people are spending, these fiction publishers are spending on ads to their books. So it's somewhere in the neighborhood just to like launch your first book, because you need to build an email list, you need to build a following, you need to create attention for your book. People will spend $10,000 to $20,000.
But definitely thousands of dollars. And if you want to take this seriously and do it real, like for real, then $10,000 plus.
Yeah.
Like you need to have $20,000 sitting in the bank right now if you want to take fiction publishing seriously.
Yeah. If you just have a few grand, you cannot do this.
Mm-hmm.
You could do it, but you will fail, and you'll wish that you'd listened to us and just gone to nonfiction.
Right. Now, I want to say running ads, the fact that this is a part of fiction is not a bad thing.
No, like, running ads is good.
Ads are great for any business, and it's not wrong or anything. Just keep in mind that you need this money up front, and you're not going to be paid by Amazon until 60 days later. So you're not going to get it back until then.
Yeah.
So you literally need the money now. It's going to be gone for 2 months. And then you'll get it back.
And one very, very, very important thing to know about fiction publishing is you see these massive screenshots of massive income reports. Like fiction publishers, they like to flaunt their publishing income, like, oh, I made 50K this month. What they're not showing you is they might literally have spent 50K or more in Facebook ad spend and Amazon ad spend as well. Maybe they only spent 40K. So, oh, then you still made 10,000 profit.
Which
That's great.
Which is great.
But you can do that in nonfiction as well.
But it's not like, whoa, yeah. How did you do that? I can't do that anywhere else. Only fiction.
Like,
no, it's not like
what
that.
They're not showing you is their massive Facebook ad spend.
Some will make 50K in royalties and spend 52K in ads.
Absolutely. Like, they're losing money. But look, I made 50K this month.
Yeah.
Like, but in reality, a lot of people are not just truthful about their incomes.
And again, that's not to say that's everyone.
But no, not at all. Not just
it's common.
Just
right?
Saying those people exist.
Now, I also want to say I'm not here to just shit on fiction publishing. This is my true and honest experience with it. That's why I don't choose to do it, and why I don't recommend to anyone. There are good things about it, but here I'm just saying why I don't recommend it.
But nonfiction is easier and better for making money.
Absolutely. Okay.
And also, everything we're saying in this video, all of the 5 points, these are all just facts.
Mm-hmm.
They are facts that can't really be disputed very much.
Okay, the fifth one is, I think, the biggest one. You know, you said the last one was, I think this one is, and that is that it's not passive.
Passive income.
Mm-hmm. It's not passive at all, right? You are working very hard with this. Like, when it comes to nonfiction,
that's the great thing about nonfiction.
Yeah.
It can be super passive. Let me just show that it's super passive. In a lot of videos, I put on like all the screen income reports from like months of my nonfiction publishing business where I hadn't touched it in like 9 months and made $50,000 in royalties.
Now, this could never happen with fiction. If you just let go, you cut off all ads, you cut off all emails, you didn't respond to anyone,
it dies off instantly.
Oh, you'll get down to a few $100 a month maybe.
Yeah.
Right? After making 10,000 plus. So, it's just so much work.
This goes back to, again, one of the great things about publishing is it's passive like no other business in the world is.
Yeah.
Nonfiction, again.
But once you go into fiction, it's suddenly not passive at all. So what are these things that make fiction not passive? So you have to continuously maintain Facebook ads. Uh-huh. Every day you have to go in and adjust, make changes, all that. Reply to emails, maintain a Facebook page, reply to all comments, run promotions, set up email sequences. Every time you launch a book, there's a whole massive thing that goes into it. It's just so different than nonfiction publishing. You can't even compare them. Now, this is everything that I went through myself. And in the end, I was just, now, I just want to say, I'm maybe not 10K, I'm maybe between 5 and 10K in the hole from my fiction experiment, right? That's just me. Others, the more success with it. And I are having success with it.
The more valuable thing you lost was your time.
And I spent a lot of time on that.
You could have been publishing nonfiction instead.
Yeah, I did that on the side as well. I wish I focused 100% on that.
Yeah.
But so, I learned so much from it, so I don't regret it.
So the big takeaway for this, I think a lot of the people watching this video is people who are publishing nonfiction, they're having success, they're doing well, but they're seeing these other fiction publishers flaunting income reports of like 20, 30, 50K in income. Like, oh, no one in nonfiction does that. I want to get into fiction because I'm going to make way more money.
They're having intense feelings of shiny object syndrome.
Yeah, intense feelings of shiny object syndrome. What I want to say is if you're in nonfiction and you're doing great and you want to like, because you can't publish nonfiction forever because it's just, you want more than just that.
You're not going to be a millionaire from publishing.
Yeah, so you want to move on to the next thing. And fiction is a big obvious one because, oh, you're experienced in publishing and there's other people making a lot of money. I would highly advise against that because you're simply just, first of all, you're just going sideways.
You're just building another publishing business.
You're just building another publishing business and you don't know what you're getting yourself into. It is not necessarily better than what you've been working on. I personally think it's not better.
Yeah.
It's a worse business model because of all the things we mentioned today.
The only reason why you should do it is because you love books, you love publishing, and you want to maintain this business for years. But if you're here to make money and like an entrepreneur the way we are, I'm here to build something much bigger.
Yeah.
You know?
So much rather
fiction business is not that.
Much rather maybe start a YouTube channel. You talk about publishing there, or you could. There's a lot of options.
Consulting, social media marketing, agency, real estate, whatever. I don't know.
Talk about that in another video. But the last thing I wanted to talk about, the big thing about a fiction publishing business, people don't realize is, I'm going to put the picture on the screen right here. This is a graphic from Sam Ovens. It's something that he talks a lot about. As you can see, there's a big lion or monster, which is your business. And then there is a chain connected to your neck, which is what a lot of people experience in entrepreneurship in general. They become a slave to their businesses. And with nonfiction publishing, that is not the case. Like, oh, that's the great thing about nonfiction. But fiction is a great example of this. You can become a slave to it because it needs constant shitloads of ad spend. It needs your attention all the time. You can't take time off. You just need to constantly maintain it to keep your income alive. I really don't want people going down that rabbit hole if they're expecting something a lot better than what they're already working on, because it's just, that won't be the case.
Now, please, I really, really want to have a discussion about this in the comment section. If you disagree, let us know what you disagree with. And I'm very open-minded to have my mind change if you come with something I've never heard before. But I do have experience with this. I've done it myself.
So that brings us up to the last thing, which is the magic emoji of the day. Let's do that monster face, that red gremlin-looking troll face. Okay. Because fiction is about like stories and monsters. Makes sense. That was the best connection I could make. Yep. So drop that down below. Like the video if you liked what you heard. Subscribe. Check out all the other videos on our channel. We talk all about publishing. Nonfiction publishing, because that's what we'd recommend. And yeah, that's the end of the video. See you guys in the next one.